My name is David Argue. I'm a programmer with the Mayo Clinic, and I'm here to talk about a digital format for a next generation paper that we've developed in my lab. And you can feel free to check out either during the presentation here or afterwards the format. It's online at the address there. And please note the NGP does have to be in capital letters, so that's a common typo. The focus of the prototype can be summed up with a single letter, V. It's the view within the MVC architecture, Model View Controller architecture, which is a software architecture. The model being the raw data, either in XML, CSV, or database, or some format such as that. The view then renders that data into a format that the user can interact with, and then the controller receives input from that user and communicates with both the view and the model. The goals of creating this prototype were really pretty simple. Number one, we wanted a very clean interface that's not cluttered or distracting. Number two, we want real easy navigation from one section to the next. We also want the reader to maintain focus when they're reading through the paper. That just boosts comprehension and enjoyment of the reading experience. And ideally, we wanted to implement the prototype using non-proprietary software implementation. So here we have the format that we've developed. It's viewed in a web browser, as you can imagine. It retains the traditional paper elements, the abstract, introduction, methods, et cetera. Has a very clean interface. Really invites focus on the paper. And navigation is real simple. You can either use the buttons across the top or the arrow buttons at either the top or the bottom of each section. Now, the driving force behind development of this prototype was a next-generation imaging technology developed by one of my colleagues. We use zebrafish as the model organism in our lab, and he developed a technology where you could put a fish in a capillary tube and then rotate it, and I'll show you a video here in a minute, but the data in my lab is real visual. The expression patterns of the gene manipulation that we do are often shown in like a red fluorescent protein such as this. And when it came time to publish my colleague's work, we knew that the traditional channels of scientific publication just weren't going to do it justice. It's standard in the industry for any kind of multimedia video to be basically ostracized to the supplementary material section of the paper, and it just doesn't do it justice if you can't have it right in line. So what we discussed in our lab is what we need is a Harry Potter style paper, like you see here, where the multimedia can be right there embedded within the text. And we couldn't get this to work in PowerPoint, so I'm going to jump to the actual paper here. Whoops. So if you're perusing the paper, you come across a link, you can instantly click on it, pop up a high-definition video, and here you see the red dots are fluorescently tagged red blood cells that you can see circulating through the fish's cardiovascular system. And it's a pretty impressive video. You can imagine that without this type of format right within the paper, you just lose a lot if you try to describe it by text or just a static picture. All right, so equally as important as the multimedia is the ability to have full high-resolution images as part of the paper, and again, without having to jump to the supplementary materials section of the paper. So the NGP format allows any reference to an image, or you can either click on text or a small thumbnail to reveal the full resolution image and really see all the data that's there. Another nice feature is if you're on a multi-touch device like an iPad, you can pinch and zoom in further to get even more information. So any MVC view implementation should really be device agnostic so that a viewer or reader on one device is seeing basically the same data and having the same experience as a reader on a different device. The format that we developed runs on virtually any platform, although our testing has been limited to the devices we had on hand. We really didn't have any Android devices or some of the new tablets that are coming out. So I encourage you to test on those and, you know, send me an email, give me some feedback if it works, if you find any bugs with it. In addition to the next generation devices, we felt it was important to support some backward compatibility. A lot of libraries out there don't have the latest and greatest in technology, so having a lightweight solution that could run on their older technology seemed to be real important. So ideally, the person at the publisher who's laying out a paper, anytime a figure or a table is referenced, they'd put the figure or table right there, so it's right at your fingertips. But, you know, this never happens. You've all experienced the page flipping, trying to figure out which figure they're talking about. One feature of the NGP format that we've implemented is a simple pop-up that when a figure is referenced in the text, you can just mouse over it or tap if you're using an iPad or touch device. Instantly reveals a visual reminder of which image or table is being referenced, and then you can get back right to reading the paper. There's no jumping to a different section or a different page to find that out. And this really keeps the reader focused on the task at hand. Real similar feature I'm sure you've all seen with the pop-up citations. You just mouse over it, pops up the citation, and then a live link to the paper itself. And also in the references section, live links, of course, to the PubMed or wherever that paper will be located. So I think you guys recognize our old PC and Mac friends. They're different people. They have different preferences, different tastes. Maybe they both love science and reading about science, but they would like things presented in a different format. And with the NGP paper, it's very easy to do that. We can do all kinds of personalization from color schemes, font details, text alignment, different layouts, and they can have it the way they want it. So the implementation of this format, we want it to be standards-based, open source. We wanted it to be lightweight, and as such, it seemed that HTML and JavaScript was pretty much the only way to go. It's lightweight, so it performs real well on the mobile devices you see today, and as well as backward compatibilities to a certain point. I lost my screen here. The standard compliant HTML is enhanced with JavaScript libraries to perform the advanced functionality like the multimedia pop-ups, the image pop-ups that you see. We used a couple libraries, one called Multibox for the lightbox pop-ups. WZTIP is for the tooltips, and there's literally dozens of similar libraries to this out there, but we chose these for their advanced feature sets, configurability, and their ability to work on a broad range of devices. And the best thing about them is that they're free. So this is just a prototype, as I mentioned. There are future directions we could try to push this. More integration with the model and the controller part of the MVC architecture. Some of the scientists in my lab requested an ability to take notes in the margins on screen and then either email those notes or, you know, be able to print all that out together. Additional personalization options, further device testing, as I mentioned, and then the ability to share the paper easily with Twitter, Facebook, or other tools like that. One important thing to note, I'd say, is kind of like the comments about eating our own dog food yesterday. This prototype was developed through a real iterative and incremental process between myself and the scientists in my lab. They've been real frustrated with the HTML implementations on the web today, and we had a survey in our lab meeting the other day to see who jumps to the HTML version versus the PDF that's out there. And pretty much they all said they want to get right to the PDF. It's just a lot easier to read. Whereas my format, they seem to really like it. It's simple, the ease of use, and I've actually had requests from a few of them to convert papers that they were going to present in a journal club meeting into the NGP format, both to go through in the journal club format as well as to distribute to the people attending. So I think it kind of speaks volumes that this is, I think I'm on the right page here and may have some features that could be brought into whatever solution we, or direction we had as a result of this conference. I'd like to thank Phil and all the meeting organizers here. I really appreciate the venue and the timing of this event. I'm from Minnesota and it's supposed to be 17 degrees below zero tonight, so I appreciate getting the heck out of there. And absolutely, yep. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wonderful, wonderful stuff. I think that this really, for me at least, throws up the question of how do we interoperate and how do we work together. And it suddenly struck me that if we could have some platforms that were agnostic enough for everybody to be able to develop on and were managed as platforms so that we could all kind of develop on them, and I think obviously there were developers from the talks yesterday that were doing the same kind of thing, then we would actually be able to synergize our efforts and move forward and really kind of collaborate in a proactive kind of way. So have you developed this with that in mind as an open platform for people such as myself to be able to develop tools to put into this kind of thing?
We really didn't. Honestly, the prototype was really developed as a tool to push our current publisher in this direction. As you can imagine, it's been difficult, to say the least. I think the takeaway is that the implementation here, it's really quite simple. There's nothing magic about what I've done. It's using industry standard implementations. I imagine the different publishers would, you know, could potentially grab this and put their own spin on it, but I agree that we don't want to be reinventing the wheel and duplicating efforts. So if we can build this and implement things, and the use of JavaScript libraries to do some of the things that we've had, you know, we can all grab pieces of that to implement. But yeah, we definitely don't want to be reinventing the wheel.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Hello? Oh, okay. Hi, I noticed that you have nice live links to the vendors where you got all of your information. Is there, do you work with the vendors in order to make sure that they don't, you know, get a new jazzy site and then all those links break?
Yeah, that's a good question. We haven't really gotten that far. This is a prototype, but, you know, hopefully we can work out some sort of solution like that. It is a benefit, definitely, to work with the vendors and for them to provide a solution so that, you know, when you reference that there's a certain tubing that you use, that you can link directly to that vendor's page to order that exact tubing to duplicate the efforts within the paper. So I think they would be motivated to find a common solution that would prevent that from happening.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you again.